Hello children, welcome back. So what shall we go about today? Choice is yours. Shall we go with another poem or a lesson? I'll give you two options. One serious poem or a humorous story of yours. Which one do you choose? Of course, it's only the humorous story you all would go about. Even my choice is the same because we have ended up in the other session learning that all men are equal. All are the children of the God and no men are foreign. We have ended up. So now to change our mood, let's get into another humorous story. So this story is nothing but Packing is an extract taken from a novel called Three Men in Boat written by Jerome K. Jerome. 2 years ago, the batches which have given their examinations in our school also, children, as we have opted for communicative English and Vinyan. So we used to have this as one of the novels where really children used to enjoy thoroughly the whole of novel, even the teachers as well. So now you are blessed at least to have an extract from that humorous novel. Because now what you have opted is language and literature. Am I right? So we shall go about. So the lesson is Packing. It's an extract taken from Three Men in Boat written by Jerome K. Jerome. So all of you, please quickly take this down in your running notes and also have your textbook along. And as I said, this is a humorous story, and then especially in this particular episode, that is an extract taken, which is called Packing, has got four characters. So all of you please note down even the characters which are very important. First one is the narrator, he himself, that is Jerome K. Jerome. Then his first friend is Harris. Then he has also got another friend whose name is George. And finally another companion of their tour, that is Montmorency. It's a dog. So how many characters in all total together we have here? There are four characters. I believe all of you might have taken this down in your notebook as well. That's great. So, the whole story revolves around these four characters. So, as soon as you hear the word packing, packing has many meanings depending on its own context. Am I right? Contextually, the word packing has many meanings. So, now here, packing is nothing but whenever somebody plans for a tour or a journey, the way we pack the things, our own belongings, the clothes and all necessary things and other things, whatever we require, the cam to capture the photos, isn't it? So all these kind of things, you know, we pack very properly and take along. So that's what is the packing we are speaking in this lesson about. So in this lesson, they just have given an activity before starting the lesson, children. So please open page number 82. So before you read, they are just giving you an exercise. This you can do it for yourself, answering verbally to yourself. You do not write. First question, do you like going on trips? What kind of trips do you enjoy the most? So if at all somebody questions me the same thing, of course an obvious and instant answer would be, yes, I enjoy. And what sort of places do you enjoy the most? Of course the pilgrimage centers and even hill stations with family. That's my choice. I just have given a nice shade. Similarly, you please answer to yourself that do you like to go on tours? If so, what sort of places would you like to visit? Next question. How do you feel about having to pack for a trip? Of course, whenever we plan for a trip or a tour, you know, children, you all pack all the necessary things, whatever we need to carry along. Then how about packing? Are you interested or not? Do you do it perfectly or not? Next question. Funny question, children. Have you ever discovered on a trip that you have forgotten to pack a few things you very much need or that you cannot find them easily? Many a times this could have been happened in our lives. Though we, like, you know, especially when it comes to my own situation, I always make a list of all the things needed to be carried along. I make a very proper list. And then as soon as I pack everything and I cross-check as well that yes, I took it or not. If not yet, then I will immediately place it. But even then sometimes, you know, there is something, a minute thing which I forget. Usually it happens with me. Then how about you? if it is a necessary thing, like a medicine, if you forget and if you don't find it at the place where you visit, then what would be the thing? Just try to imagine. So they're just asking that. How important is packing when you plan for a tour or a journey? It is of course very, very important. If it is a silly thing which you have forgotten, then it's not a problem. If at all you have forgotten to pack your dresses, all that's not a problem. Because you can buy anywhere, wherever you go, there is a provision, right? But when it comes to something, you know, medicines and all, sometimes we don't need it. So yes, of course, packing is very important. The next. Does this make you angry? Or does it make you laugh at yourself? So it all depends on, like they are just asking a question. Have you ever experienced that you have forgotten something as you are packing and before leaving for the tour and after you reach the place where you have already traveled to and then you discovered that you have forgotten something? Then that something, did it make you feel angry or you laughed at yourself that you have left something which is silly? Both the things might have happened. Like as I have already given you the instance, if it is a medicine which is not available outside, then of course you will be angry. And if it is a silly thing as a mirror or something, if at all you haven't carried along, then you need not worry, or a cap or something, you can easily buy somewhere and they just love it. Am I right? Yes. So now read this description of how the author and his friends pack. So let me tell you children, the background before we enter into the story, there are three friends. One is our own author, that is Jerome K. Jerome. And also he had very good, like close friends you can call them. One is Harris and George. So three of them, you know, they were just fed up of working for long and long hours and like months together without availing any leave or a holiday. So they were completely fed up and frustrated. Then one fine day somebody suggests, you know, that why don't we go on a long trip? Why don't we sail? They wanted to like just make in a boat to travel to certain place. This was an idea given by one of them. Then they think that fine, this is the only way where they can make themselves being away from their office work. Because they were fed up of their office work, working long hours without taking any leave or any holiday. Then they played, like made their plan, everything is done, and they just thought fine, now it's a nice fine day, so let's start. Then the problem started. Then the main important thing, which is packing, you know. Then each one of them, they consider themselves to be the very perfectionists in the packing. Everybody think that they are highly skilled in packing all the things whenever they plan for the tour or the journey. So the first chance would be given to our author, that is the narrator, Jerome K. Jerome. So now the whole lesson goes in the first person because it is nothing but the version of narration. So narrator, he himself, Jerome K. Jerome, he is speaking to all of us. So the story here in the extract of three men in boat started where they already planned for their tour and now it is the time, it is the moment where they will need to make the whole packing done. So let's see what are all the things they come across. Please look at the paragraph 1, page number 82, and also please have your running notes along. I said I would pack. So they might have had a discussion that who would pack all the things and all. So it was Jerome K. Jerome who immediately responded saying that you need not really worry and you need not bother, I shall pack. So it's my duty, I would take care of the whole of packing. I rather pride myself on my packing. So he feels, he's saying himself that I'm proud of my skill of packing. I'm very good at packing. Like he's saying himself that I'm proud. And packing is one of those many things that I feel I know more about than any other person living. And he says himself, like, you know, self-appraisal. He's complimenting himself saying that whatever and how much ever the skill I have about the packing, nobody else would have that kind of a skill as how I had. So I am the greater than anyone else. That is how he is saying that when it comes to packing. He is saying that. Then it surprises me myself sometimes how many such things there are. Then he himself is saying, oh my God, I am very good at packing. I am very good at many other things also. I surprise myself that how many things I am good at. So see the funny way he is just complimenting himself. Actually compliment is considered to be the wonderful thing when it is received from somebody else, isn't it, children? So self compliment is something, you know, we don't consider sometimes. So I impressed the fact upon George and Harris and told them that they had better leave the whole matter entirely to me. So what did he do? Jerome K. Jerome, he himself has suggested to make George and Harris to sit properly away, happily enjoy, because Jerome is going to take care of the whole of packing. He said that it's my suggestion and it's I suggested them to just sit aside so that I can take care of the whole packing. Then what happened then? Then they fell into the suggestion with a readiness that had something uncanny about it. Then they felt that fine, because they're all good friends, children, so they all know about each other since long, right? Then they felt that fine, this is Jerome and this is his matter of thinking, so let us not disturb him. So just let it go on the same way. Then they fell into the, like they just have used the phrase, like the phrase you see that fell into the suggestion is nothing, but they accepted immediately. When Jerome had suggested that he would take care of the packing, whole packing in fact, then they immediately accepted. And it was not strange for them because they knew about Jerome's nature well in advance and well in before, because they're all friends since so long. So immediately they accepted, thinking that fine, that this is not anything which is strange about it. Then George spread himself over the easy chair. So when everything was ready, Jerome was ready to start packing, and whereas George had spread himself over the easy chair. Easy chair, you all know it now, where we can like lean back and stretch our legs forward and happily we can relax. So George has taken like just the place on the easy chair, relaxing more. Then Harris cocked his legs on the table. Then Harris was also sitting on one of the chairs and immediately he stretched his both the feet onto the table in front of him. So both of them, if at all you try to visualize their postures, children, that definitely you will find them being relaxing. It's nothing but the relaxing mode they are in. Now, paragraph 2. This was hardly what I intended. So, Jerome is speaking, yes, by looking at both the friends, you know, yes, this is what I want. Because I don't want them to intrude into this matter. I don't want them to interfere into this matter. And I want my friends to be seated separately, away from this work, whereas I can take the whole responsibility of packing. What I had meant, of course, was that I should boss the job. So see how crazy Jerome here is. Why did he say so? Why is he taking the whole of responsibility on his head of the packing of a whole thing, of all the three people there? When there are three people traveling, then at least two people can help each other, not just to make the packing done. But no, Jerome said that, no, I don't want to take help from anybody. You just relax, I can just take care. Because the main reason behind taking the responsibility is that I want to boss. Boss in the sense, I want to monitor. I want to dominate others. I want to take care completely. So I want to be the head of this job. So the main motto of Jerome K was to just be the boss for the job. Just to head the job. And that Harris and George should potter about under my directions. Then what he says, so when I act as a boss, then I want George and Harris to be my inferiors. Because he's a superior, he's feeling. So my helper. So I want my friends, both the friends, George and Harris, to just assist me in my packing. And they need to potter about. Potter about, they just have mentioned the word, children. Do something unimportant things. You know, when he completely occupies the place where he makes everything done ready for the packing, then he may ask George, get me that. And please pick me that and pick and get me that kind of an order. Like, you know, he can just pass it to his friends and he would like to give them the unimportant things to be done. Whereas Jerome would like to take care of the whole of the thing. So, it shows that he would like to be the superior always. And I pushing them aside every now and then saying, oh, you, here, let me do it. There you are. Simple enough. Really teaching them, as you might say. So, while, as I said, that he would like to be the superior there, ordering his both the friends to do the silly things and unimportant things, and when they start venturing, when they start doing the things what are being instructed by Jerome also, he would like to say, no, it's not like that, come on, you are unnecessarily obstructing me, don't do this, do this. So he would like to always command his friends. That's what he would enjoy, that commanding. Then they're taking it in the way that it irritated me. So he feels that when these kind of instructions are given to his friends And as they start doing it according to the instructions given also, the way they do it sometimes would irritate me. Jerome is speaking to us that they would irritate. There is nothing that irritates me more than seeing other people sitting about doing nothing when I am working. See the nature of Jerome, children. It's so funny. He himself is asking his friends to be seated aside, not to interfere in the packing. And he would like to take the whole responsibility of packing he himself. That was Jerome. He himself told that. Now he says that sometimes I am so much like very much irritated by looking at my friends where I see them sitting very comfortably relaxing, whereas I am doing a lot of work. So there is a mismatch in his thinking. He himself is thinking that he doesn't want the help from others. And again he comments that he can't see the people sitting simply without helping him. So what is he wanting? He is wanting his friends to assist him with all unimportant things where they commit something wrong, where he can correct their mistakes. So he would like to always be the boss. That was his nature. So we shall continue from third paragraph in next session, children. So I believe all of you might have understood, and maybe there is a lot of desperate interest in you all to know about what is further going to happen. Because an interesting character dog is left as we haven't touched yet. So before we end up, let's sum up. So Packing is an extract taken from a novel that is Three Men in Boat, written by Jerome K. Jerome. And it's a narration format where you see Jerome talking to all of us. There are three friends, Jerome, George and Harris. Three of them were close friends. And one fine day they are just fed up and they would like to run away, leaving their job on leave, and they would like to enjoy their life. So they have decided to go on sailing by engaging a boat. Then the plan of packing has come, whereas Jerome has given a promise to his friend saying that it's my responsibility, I take the whole responsibility of packing. That is how and that is where the story began, and let's continue in the next session. As I shall be serving you the worksheet, children, please do attempt, and if time permits, please go through the lesson also. You will also definitely burst out into laughter. So let's meet in the next session. This is Vijaya signing off.